Hello friends, welcome back to STM Tutorials. Myself Ajinkya and we are here to learn embedded system on STM32F103 controller. So let's begin. In the last video, we saw the circuit diagram and the main function of the mini project. So we will continue with the remaining functions. So let's begin. We will see few functions in this video. The keypress function is same as that shown in the keypad interface video. So, we have not changed anything except the GPIO port connections. So, for row connections, we are using PB0 to PB3 and for column connections, we are using PB4 to PB7. That is the only change in the keypress function. The check column function is also same. We have not changed anything except the GPIO port connections. For column connections, we are using pin 4 to pin 7 of GPIO port B. So we have changed only the column connections, that is GPIO 4, GPIO 5, GPIO 6 and GPIO 7 of GPIO port B. Both the functions of LCD are explained in the LCD interface video. So LCD initialization and LCD functions are explained in the LCD interface video. The GPIO port connectivity is exactly same as that shown in the LCD interface video. So you can refer to the LCD interface video for connection and explanation of the code. Now coming to LCD string function. The LCD string function accesses the string by using the pointer. So we have accessed the string by call by reference method. The while loop in LCD string function checks for the null character in the string. The string is always terminated by a null character. So the while loop will run till the null character is detected in the string. The LCD function displays the characters in the string and the pointer is incremented in the next line. The dispass function is written to display the key pressed and to compare it with the correct pass key. The pressed key will be stored in the key array of 5 elements. The correct pass key is written in the enter key array. The pass key is taken in the key var variable. If the key is not pressed, the key var variable value will be 16. Else it will be the pressed key value in between 0 to 15. In the if loop, the passed key is stored in the key array. And the pass key is added with 48 to make it the ASCII characters. The ASCII value is then passed to LCD function to display on the LCD. The pass variable is incremented by 1 on line 125. On the next line, if the pass variable is incremented to 5, that means all 5 keys are stored in the array, the program will compare the entire array with the correct pass key. The LCD function call on line 128 will take the cursor on second line first position of the LCD. The for loop compares the entered key with the correct pass key. The entered key is stored in the key array and the correct pass key is in the enter key array. One by one characters in both the arrays are compared. If any one character is mismatched, then if loop will display re-enter password on the LCD and will come out of the loop with resetting the pass variable to 0. And if all 5 values are matched, then LCD will display the string welcome. After that, the delay of 3 seconds is given. The pass variable value is reset to 0. The LCD is cleared and the cursor position is set to first line first position. The LCD will again display enter password on the first line of the LCD and the cursor position is again set to second line first position of the LCD. If no key is pressed, key var variable value will be equals to 16 and display key function will come out of the if loop. Now let's build the code, load the hex file into controller and see whether our code is working properly or not. This time we will enter the correct passkey and we will check the system's response. I'll share the code and the simulation file on the Telegram channel. If you enjoy the video, click on like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to watch our other videos also. Thanks for watching the video. And don't forget to watch our basic electronics video linked above. We will see you in the next video.